Hi friends, welcome back to my new lecture. Today we are going to discuss about water cooling system, and in that water cooling system we are going to discuss about thermosiphon cooling system. In the water coolant system there are various types like thermosiphon cooling system, next is thermosiphon cooling system with thermostatic valve, and third one is a pressure cooling system. So one by one we are going to discuss about all three. Today we are going to discuss about thermosiphon cooling system. Let's go for the thermosiphon cooling system. In this particular figure I have shown you one jeep or the vehicle is there, and in that I have highlighted the engine part. So you can see that this is the engine of the vehicle, and this particular part which is called as a radiator. So this frontal part is radiator on which air can flow. So engine is there, radiator is there, and we are having a radiator fan. So we can observe that there is a radiator fan is also present. This is a simple diagram which shows that where is the location of thermosiphon cooling system. Basically this thermosiphon cooling system not uses any kind of external device to move the water inside a system. Like in the other type of system we use pumps etc., but in this system we are not using any kind of system. That's what called as a thermosiphon cooling system. So this particular figure clears you where is the location of the cooling system. Generally it is provided at the front. If it is thermosiphon cooling system, it is provided at the front. Now let us see how it works. So this shows some detailed diagram of thermosiphon cooling system. Let's understand which part is provided where. Here you have to assume that in this particular portion there is a piston cylinder arrangement. So piston cylinder arrangement is not specifically shown here. Here there will be piston cylinder arrangement, and this particular portion shows that radiator. So this is the radiator through which air will be provided, and this will be provided at the front. So this particular portion will be at the front, whereas on the back side this will be a rear portion. So this will be a rear side. Okay, so frontal part is here and the air can flow over this one. Right, now behind this radiator what we are having is the radiator fan. This particular part is called as radiator fan. At the same time here when there is a piston cylinder arrangement, around that water galleries will be present or coolant galleries will be present through which the coolant will be moving. So this coolant here in this particular figure it has shown the watermark all over, but if you see actual engine there will be water galleries present, and through that water galleries only water can move. Okay, so you have to assume that there will be engine number, piston cylinder arrangement number 1, piston cylinder arrangement number 2, piston cylinder arrangement number 3 and 4, around that water is flowing. Now this engine part and radiator part, they are connected by hose connection. You can see that here there is upper hose connection and this particular part is called as lower hose connection. Hose means what? It's a rubber pipe which is connected and which is flexible. So upper pipeline is connected to upper portion of the radiator, lower pipeline is connected to lower portion of the radiator, and in between we are having radiator pipes. Okay, so this is what on construction. Let's see how it works, how actual working of this particular happens. Now when engine gets started means fuel get burned. As the fuel get burned, what happened? The water around that piston cylinder arrangement will get heated. So temperature of that water will get increased. As the temperature increases, you should know that the water becomes lighter. It reduces its density and it becomes lighter. When water becomes lighter, water tries to move in upward side. When the water becomes lighter, it will try to move in upward side direction. Means what? The lighter water will try to move in upward side direction and through the hose like this. So here we have shown that through the hose it will be moving like this. So hot water will be moving like this, and hot water will be accumulated in this particular zone of the radiator. What is there in radiator? In radiator we are having a tubes in which water will be flowing, and over the tube air will be flowing, that is atmospheric air. Okay, so inside a pipeline we are having the water, and over the pipeline what will happen is the atmospheric air will be flowing. So this is atmospheric air will be flowing. Now atmospheric air temperature will be less and the water temperature will be high. So let's say water temperature is near about 100 degrees Celsius. So 100 degrees Celsius water is there, and atmospheric air, let's consider it's a 30 degrees Celsius. Because of this difference in temperature, there will be heat transfer. Heat transfer from what? Heat transfer from hot component to the cold component. What is the hot body here? Hot body is the water, which is at 100 degrees Celsius. What is the cold body? Cold body is air. So there will be heat exchange from high temperature to low temperature, means the heat will be flowing from 100 degrees Celsius to 30 degrees Celsius. The result of this, the temperature of water will go on reduces. The temperature of water get reduces. As the temperature of water inside a tube get reduces, what happen is the water becomes heavier. Remember, this is opposite to what happened here. Here it was become lighter and here it will become heavier. Why it will become heavier here? Because it gets cool. Once it will become heavier, the water starts moving on a downside direction. So heavier water, that is cold water, will start moving on downside direction. It will come on downside, and from downside again it goes to the engine. Okay, means what? This is a cycle that towards engine it will get heated and in the radiator it will get cool, and this cycle will go on repeating. Here one thing which is very important, that we have not observed any kind of external device like pump used for movement of the water. Water has traveled from where to where? Water has traveled from engine, it has gone for radiator, from radiator again it has come to the engine like this. So there is a continuous circulation part of the water, and hence what will happen? There will be cooling of the engine. This is all about what we have discussed, the thermosiphon cooling system. Thank you very much for listening.